We can observe in our home, if we supply constant rated voltage to our load, at some point of time it can be suddenly fallen from its rated voltage. That can happen because of short circuits or overloads or anything. So that voltage drop or voltage fallen or voltage dip is also known as voltage sag. Okay, what is the voltage sag? If you supply the constant voltage to your load, at some point of time it will be fallen from the rated voltage. That effect is known as voltage sag. We can see regularly in our home, if bulb is getting 240 volts in ideal condition, it will be glow like normal. Okay, if you give the less than 240 volts, means you can decrease the voltage, then what will happen? It will be glow like lighter, right? So that condition is known as this voltage sag. And we also have another effect that is totally opposite to this voltage sag, that is known as voltage swell. Okay, what is voltage sag? You can get the less than the normal voltage, right? But in voltage sag, if you supply the constant voltage, at some point of time you can get the more than the rated voltage. Okay, nothing but higher than the rated voltage. That effect is known as voltage swell. In that condition, the bulb will be supplied greater than the rated voltage, then our light will be glow more than the normal ideal condition, that is the swell condition. So these two effects are also lead to affect the power quality. Okay, so in this project we need to improve this power quality. To improve this power quality, we need to eliminate this voltage sag and voltage swell. So let's see how to eliminate this voltage sag and voltage swell in distribution grid. Here is our project title. What is our project title? Improving power quality of the distribution. So we need to improving the power quality at what? At distribution level. Okay, using what? Using integrated dynamic voltage restorer. Okay, with the ultra capacitor. Here we need to improve the power quality at distribution level by using the DVR with the ultra capacitor. This is the our project title. I already told you how to improve power quality. To improve power quality, we need to eliminate the voltage sag and voltage swell, right? So here actually our project will be at distribution level. Okay, distribution means it is nearer to load. Okay, so it is nearer to load means what? It is like short transmission line or medium transmission line. Okay, so in short transmission line or medium transmission line, what we need to use? We need to use a AC transmission line only. Okay, why? Because this is the distribution point. That's why I'm taking only AC transmission line. So here we are taking the source. Here I am taking the load. Okay, this is the AC transmission line. So at any situation, it is possible to getting the fault like voltage sag or voltage swell. First of all, we are taking the voltage sag condition. Voltage sag condition means what? For example, we need to give the load to 240 volts, but at some instance, but due to some fault, we are getting only 200 volts. Okay, that is the fault condition. To eliminate this fault, we need to give another 40 volts, then only we maintain the load required voltage. Okay, so how to inject these 40 volts to the system? So that's why we are taking the DVR. So DVR means nothing but, here we have some source, nothing but the DC source. Okay, so here actually I am taking the DC source. Why? Because I am taking DC source, actually we can't store the AC. Okay, we can't see any batteries in AC. Okay, we have the storage element with only DC only. That's why I'm taking the DC source. Okay, but our transmission line will be AC, right? So to convert this DC to AC, we need to connect here inverter, right? So inverter can convert this DC to pulsating AC, not pure AC. Okay, again, to convert this pulsating AC to pure AC, we need to connect another passive filter. Okay, with the help of combination of L and C. This is the combination of L and C, that is the passive filter. Okay, then we directly connect to the transmission line with the help of transformer seriously. Okay, we are connecting the transformer here with the series connection. Why? Because our DVR, nothing but the dynamic voltage restorer, is one of the series FETs compensator. ఓకే, ఇట్ ఈస్ వన్ ఆఫ్ ది సిరీస్ కాంపెన్సేటర్ ఇన్ ఫ్యాక్ట్ డివైజెస్, దట్స్ వై ఐఎమ్ కనెక్టింగ్ ద సిరీస్ టు ద ట్రాన్స్మిషన్ లైన్. సో హియర్ ఐఎమ్ టేకింగ్ ద 40 వోల్ట్స్ డిసి, వెన్ అవర్ ద వోల్టేజ్ సాగ్ అక్కర్ నథింగ్ బట్ ద వెన్ అవర్ వీఆర్ గెటింగ్ ది 200 వోల్ట్స్, వీ నీడ్ టు ఇంజెక్ట్ దిస్ 40 వోల్ట్స్ టు ద సిస్టమ్, దెన్ వీ కెన్ ఈజీలీ ఎలిమినేట్ దిస్ వోల్టేజ్ సాగ్ అండ్ వీఆర్ గెటింగ్ ద రేటెడ్ వోల్టేజ్, రైట్. బట్ ద థింగ్ ఈస్ ఇఫ్ యూ గెట్ ద వోల్టేజ్ సాగ్ యూ కెన్ ఇంజెక్ట్ ద వోల్టేజ్, రైట్. వాట్ అబౌట్ వోల్టేజ్ ఫెల్? సో హియర్ ఫర్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్ ఐఎమ్ గెటింగ్ ద 280 వోల్ట్స్, మీన్స్ ఐఎమ్ గెటింగ్ ద మోర్ 40 వోల్ట్స్, రైట్. సో వీ వాంట్ ఓన్లీ 240 వోల్ట్స్, బట్ వీఆర్ గెటింగ్ ద మోర్ దెన్ ద రేటెడ్ వోల్టేజ్, దట్ ఈస్ ద వోల్టేజ్ ఫెల్, రైట్. సో హియర్ వీఆర్ గెటింగ్ ద ఎక్సెస్ ఆఫ్ 40 వోల్ట్స్. సో హౌ టు ఎలిమినేట్ దీస్ వన్? టు ఎలిమినేట్ దీస్ వన్ వీఆర్ టేకింగ్ ద, ఇన్స్టెడ్ ఆఫ్ డిసి సోర్స్ ఐఎమ్ టేకింగ్ ద వన్ అల్ట్రా కెపాసిటర్, ఓకే. సో దిస్ కెపాసిటర్ కెన్ ఏబుల్ టు స్టోర్ ద ఎనర్జీ అండ్ రిలీజ్ ద ఎనర్జీ, ఓకే. సో ఇన్ సాగ్ కండిషన్ ఇట్ కెన్ గివ్ ద వోల్టేజ్ టు ద ట్రాన్స్మిషన్ లైన్, మీన్స్ ఇట్ కెన్ రిలీజ్ ద ఎనర్జీ ఫ్రమ్ ద కెపాసిటర్ టు ద ట్రాన్స్మిషన్ లైన్, ఓకే. ఇన్ స్వెల్ కండిషన్ వీఆర్ గెటింగ్ ది ఎక్సెస్ 40 వోల్ట్స్, రైట్. సో ఎట్ దిస్ కండిషన్ కెపాసిటర్ టేక్ దట్ ఎక్సెస్ వోల్టేజ్, ఓకే, అండ్ స్టోర్డ్ ఇన్ ద కెపాసిటర్, దట్స్ వై ఐఎమ్ టేకింగ్ ద ఇన్స్టెడ్ ఆఫ్ డిసి సోర్స్ అల్ట్రా కెపాసిటర్, ఓకే. అండ్ అనదర్ పాయింట్ ఈస్ we don't get always 40 volts error, okay. Sometime we can get also, if you want 240 volts, sometime we will get also 10 volts only. So here we need to increase the 230 volts, okay. But our battery nothing but the ultra capacitor have the capacity of 40 volts only, okay. But how to convert this 40 volts to 230 volts? So that's why I'm taking the before inverter, we need to take one buck boost converter. Here if you having the problem of nothing but the fault of only 10 volts, then we need to increase 230 volts. At that condition, if you have only 40 volts, then boost converter will boost up this 40 volts to 230 volts and give it to the system. That the use of this buck boost converter, okay. Like this, in swell condition only we don't get always 40 volts, we can also get 60 to 70 volts also. At that condition, this buck converter will operate and decrease this 70 and 80 volts of the fault to 40 volts and give it to the ultra capacitor. Then ultra capacitor can store only these 40 volts only. So that is the concept of the DVR. Okay, this is the DVR. So why we call it as a dynamic voltage restorer? This ultra capacitor can restore the voltage when different types of voltage faults also occur. That is the use of DVR with the ultra capacitor. So here another point is, this buck boost converter will give different types of output at different types of fault condition, right? If you get the 200 volts fault, then this boost converter will give only 40 volts. If you get the 100 volts only, then this boost converter will give 150 volts. But in boost converter we need to get only fixed voltage only, not variable voltage, okay. That is depending on the duty cycle of this buck boost converter. So for getting the exact output, we are taking the control system, okay. Here you can take the control system like this, on plus and minus. Here we are giving the reference voltage. Reference voltage means voltage what we want. We need at load 240 volts, right. So here I am taking the voltage at system, okay, system voltage at fault condition what we are getting, okay, that voltage I am taking, okay, and give it to the one simple PA controller, and I also give it to the boost converter switch, nothing but the gate signal, okay. So to set the this duty cycle value, if you take different duty cycle values, then you can get the different output values. So for example, I'm taking, we need always 240 volts fixed voltage only, okay. At some condition, at some fault, I am getting only 200 volts. So at this situation, what will be happen? 240, this is minus, right, minus 200. So 40 volts is the error. So here we get the 40 volts error. So this PA control will told to this switch, we are getting the 40 volts only. So corresponding to this duty cycle, you can take, okay. So here boost converter will set some duty cycle to give the 40 volts output, okay. At another situation, we will get here 100 volts fault, okay. Here 240 minus 100 watt, 140. Here PA control will told to switch. Here we are getting the much more error, that is 140 volts. Here we need to increase your duty cycle. So set your duty cycle to give 140 volts. Okay. Yet another situation, you are getting the 240 volts means what you want at your load, then you can get that voltage 240 volts here. What will happen? 240 minus 240, zero. Here your error is the zero. Then PA control will told to switch. Here you are not getting the any error. So don't need to give the duty cycle. So here boost converter will not operate. So here no voltage is flows from this voltage to transmission line, right? So like this we can eliminate the voltage sag and voltage swell. So here you can take the graph. Yet some situation you are getting the less than your rated value. Okay, at this situation our DC source will operate. Okay, at this situation our DVR will operate and eject the voltage only in between. Okay, we don't need to inject at this point 0 to T1. Okay, we need to operate only T1 to T2. Okay, if you operate even 0 to T1, what will happen? Again system will be unbalanced. Means if you getting the 240 volts, again you need to inject the 40 volts, what will happen? You are getting the 280 volts, right? 280 volts. Here you are getting the 240 volts only. So again system will be unbalanced. You need to give only at fault condition. So that's why I am taking the controller to control the voltage. So like this you can eliminate the voltage sag and voltage swell. If you eliminate the voltage sag and voltage swell, what will happen? You can easily improve our power quality. So here you can able to see circuit diagram of your project. Okay, so here I'm taking the source and this is the load. This is our DVR, right? Here I'm taking the DC source as ultra capacitor. So we are getting the only low voltage here. To boost up this voltage, I'm taking the boost converter, and in swell condition I need to buck, right? That's why I'm taking the combination of boost and buck converters. Okay, again to convert this DC to AC, why? Because our transmission line will be the AC only. Okay, so convert this DC to AC. I'm taking the one inverter, that is nothing but the DC to AC inverter. So here I'm only getting the pulsating AC, not pure AC. To convert this pulsating AC to pure AC, I'm taking the one passive filter. This is the LC combination is passive filter. Then finally we are getting the exact AC and I'm going to the this transformer. So this is our circuit diagram, what I told till now. So now let's see how this circuit diagram in MATLAB. So here I will provide you two circuits, like one is for voltage sag condition and another one is for voltage swell condition. Now I will open any one circuit. Okay, so this is the our MATLAB designing for voltage sag condition. Okay, so look at this diagram. This is exactly what we have in our circuit. Okay, this is our circuit, right? Here we need to take the one source and load and one ultra capacitor, buck boost converter, inverter and passive filter to the transformer. So like this I am connecting here also. So this is the source and this is the load, R load. Okay, and here first of all I am taking the ultra capacitor. So this is the capacitor and I am connecting to the one buck boost converter. These two switches and this inductor will be known as boost converter, buck boost converter. Okay, and here I am getting the only DC. So our transmission line want to AC, that's why I am again connecting to the inverter. This is the three phase inverter. This converting the DC to pulsating AC, but here also we don't get the pure AC. That's why I need to connect the another passive filter. This is the passive filter combination of LC. Here only we are getting the exact AC. So now I am injecting this AC to our transmission line through the transformer. So this is the sub block subsystem. Here you can get the transformers. Okay, this is the three phase transformers. Okay, and give it to the load. This is our circuit diagram. And below we have the control systems block. This is the control systems block. Here I am connecting to the exact voltage. Here I am taking the exact voltage what I need. In theoretically I will tell you 240, but practically I am taking the 260. This is what we need at load, but this is the voltage we are getting at the system. Okay, this is the voltage measurement I am taking from the system. I'm giving to the some transfer function. So this is the total control block and give it to the buck boost converter circuit. So this S1 and S2 will be go to the switches. Double click this one and open this. Then this is the buck boost converter, right? I'm giving to the buck boost converter switching pulses using that controller. Okay, so this is our MATLAB circuit. If you run it, you will get the voltage like this. Okay, at sag condition we are getting the voltage sag at source side. Okay, with the help of DVR and ultra capacitor, we are eliminating this sag. So then finally we are getting the three phase AC supply like this. Here you don't have any sag condition. Here you can get, here you have the sag. Here you are eliminating that sag. That's it. At swell condition, this is the waveform. Here you are getting the exact value, but here you are getting the more value. that is greater than the rated value. So this is the voltage sag condition. But by using the DVR and the ultra capacitor, again you are eliminating the this swell fault. So finally you are getting the exact AC. So that is our project. So if you want this project, contact me. I will provide this piece paper and PPT and documentation also in description.